We will teach them to sing and dance. Wouldn't that be great?
We're at the CIA, the California Institute of Abnormalarts. What we do here is the most unusual, maximalist entertainment that you could find anywhere. Anything that stands out, anything that doesn't fade into the background, we love.
This is the greatest place in the history of the universe. A place of mystery, of secrets, of inventions, of the great mind of Carl Krug.
I've always been inspired by this place. I fell in love with it as soon as I walked in here, and Carl was probably so appropriately bizarre. I can imagine him dreaming this place in his sleep when he was 10 years old.
I love the honeymoon of California!
The CIA has been here for 18 years, and we've been developing into a place where all the freak shows that come through town can play here. They have a home, you know, to show people some stuff they've never seen. Because there's still mystery in the circus sideshow. That's why I'm so attracted to it.
I turned off education in the third grade and became a magnet for information nobody else wanted. And when I was 10 or 11, I heard the Switched On Bach album, so I taught myself to whistle. And that got me started into a lifelong obsession with dead white composers, reducing a symphony to a single melodic line, and then selling it to an audience.
Within the circus sideshow. It's about training your brain to not be lazy, to always pierce through all the mediocrity around you and go really close on things. You see stuff that's beyond your comprehension. And I love that. I like to be challenged. I don't want to be bored, you know. We just attract people that are attracted to the strange, the unusual, the different, something that's gonna jump out and slap you around, you know, in a good way, in a happy way. That's why I like all the creepy stuff, but it can't be too creepy. It's about presenting it in a way that it's scary and exciting and funny at the same time. That's what I love, you know? I wanna be scared and laughing at the same time. That is cool.
One of the best things to do for people who are squeamish or afraid of ugly things or things that might not conform to what they think is normal is to confront it directly. And I can't think of a better opportunity than to come to the CIA and see one of Carl's amazing variety shows.
Scary times at Ridgemont High, let me tell you.
Don't be scared. You don't have to be scared. Are you scared?
To be fearful of something, to be scared, you know? But then at the same time, the same level of hilarity, mix them together and child, you got a cocktail. And I ain't talking about no alcohol. I'm talking about an emotional cocktail that's really, really enjoyable and laughs with you. So I love all that stuff and we celebrate that stuff here.
The CIA carries a little bit of weight when it comes to performances because we are a non-conformist theater. The people are embracing something that's different. But in that difference is something really exceptional. And that's the beauty of this place.
Talking to somebody who never had theater experience, never had been up on a stage, never was in any sort of limelight at all. And the love for performing came from performing. It wasn't for a name and it wasn't so the audience would see me, it was really just trying to find something, trying to look for something. You know, I tried everything from trying to make movies to even play in a band. And fire eating was just one of those things where it became this passion eventually, and now that's the drive, really.
That a lot of the people within the circus sideshow are forced to have to take whatever they have that they know that they're talented with and progress with that and go for it. As an artist, you can't be afraid of anything. Screw all that. You know, let all that go. That's just nothing but baggage. You don't want any baggage. You just let it all go.
There are some people out in the world that would reject this, and I don't know why. Because in everybody's thought and thinking pattern, there's a little bit of the CIA in everybody, whether they want to admit it or not.
When one becomes acclimated to an environment of freaks and of the other, they soon make the realization that this is what's really normal, and that this is what the center of reality is. And that other world that they've left outside, the 9-to-5, everybody in bumper-to-bumper traffic on the LA freeways, that is the real freak show.
Riding down the road.